As for what happens most of the time nowadays,
في كثير من البيوت,
in many homes,
أن الناس يضيعون وقتهم فيما لا خير فيه,
is that many people waste their time with matters that are not beneficial to them.
ببرامج التلفزيون,
they watch television programs.
أو بما لا منفعة فيه,
or working online with something that is not beneficial, or playing non-beneficial games, or just looking at news that have no benefit, or other non-beneficial matters. This is not something that should be a habit of a person. This time that passes, this is your life. So you should not waste that. This is something very precious. And you should take advantage of this to build your residence in the hereafter. You should make yourself and your family accustomed to this. And you should not leave your children prey to what is spread on the different platforms, televisions, online, and all that. You remember what we mentioned yesterday about teaching people? This should also apply to the person teaching one's own children. To teach one's children and to direct them, this is something very important. And it needs, there's an effort that needs to be inserted to do so. And if the person did put effort to do so, this person would be greatly rewarded by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. As for the person that does not want to assert any effort, and just wants comfort, this person does not want to spend time with one's children to teach them and direct them and guide them, to take them to classes, lessons, to take them to the prayers, to teach them
to give
for the sake of Allah and in doing the good matters. The person that does not want to set an example for one's own children so that they could follow in one's own footsteps, and instead this person would leave one's children to spend time on television and iPads and phones and the likes. They see things that they should not. They hear things that they should not. And they learn things that they should not. At a later time, this person would be very sorrowful because of this. Would feel great sorrow because of
this.
And this sorrow, at a later time, in most cases, would not have any good outcome. It would not lead to it would not better the situation of one's children. Because this child would then be similar to a vine that has dried while it is crooked. In this case, how do you straighten that out? In such a case, most of the time, you cannot straighten that out.
وإذا أردت أن تقومه تحتاج إلى جهد كبير.
And if you did want to straighten that out, that would then need great effort.
تحتاج إلى عرضه على النار.
You need to heat this vine. You need to place this vine over fire.
حتى تستطيع أن تقومه.
So that then you would be able to straighten it out. And you might not be able to do so. So what is safe is to be keen on preserving yourself and your children when this vine is soft and lean.
Still green.
It's still green.
لأنه يكون سهلا.
Because at that time it's easy to mold it.
نعم يحتاج منك إلى جهد.
Yes, this does need effort to be exerted.
لكن هذا ليس جهدا ضايعا.
However, this is not a lost effort.
أليس ذكر النبي عليه الصلاة والسلام أن من كان له بنات ثلاث فأحسن تربيتهن كان معه في الجنة.
Is it not the case that the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam mentioned that the person that has three daughters and this person puts effort and teaches them and raises them in a well-mannered way that they would be together in paradise? Do telephones teach that?
هذا شيء ينبغي أن يأخذه كل واحد منا في الحسنان.
This is something that each one of us should take into account.
وأن لا يهمله.
And to not fall short and overlook this matter.
أليس تحط جهدا في تعليم غيرك تعليم ناس غرباء عنك ليس بينك وبينهم قرابة تعليمهم الدين.
Is it not the case that you put effort to teach strange people foreign to you, strangers to you, the matters of the religion?
إذن لماذا تهمل أولادك؟
Then why would a person overlook one's own children?
اعتبرهم كأنهم غرباء.
Consider them a stranger to you.
And
put effort in teaching them and guiding them as you would with a person that is
Israeli.
Later on, you would find in your grave what pleases you and puts you to rest. After a person dies, the reward is not renewed for a person except by three ways, and among these three ways is the righteous child of a person that makes supplication, dua, for this deceased. This was mentioned by the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam.
فلا ينبغي أن تغفل عن ذلك.
So one should not be negligent of this.
هذا أحيانا يحتاج أن لا تعطي الولد ما يريد.
Now sometimes to do this it calls to not give one's child what one's child seeks.
لأن المصلحة تكون في منعه عما يريد.
Because this child's benefit would be by preventing him or her from what they want.
فعليك أن تراعي ذلك.
And this needs to be so this is something that a person needs to take into consideration. One needs to look what is better for my child, and that is what should be done. Not to look at what is easier for me. Not to look at what will make my child like me more. For example, not to look at what would make my child like me more than his other parent, my spouse or the like. Not to look at what prevents the child from frowning in my face when looking to me. Rather, one should look what is more religiously beneficial for my child. And a person does not know what is more beneficial for their child unless one learns.
إذا كان هو يتعلم علم الدين ويسابق على مجالس العلم هذا ينفعه وينفع غيره.
So if the person himself they attend the sessions of the religious knowledge and teach others, this will help oneself and others. It will benefit oneself and others.
لأنه إذا تعلم العلم يفرق بين ما يحسن وما لا يحسن.
Because when a person learns the knowledge, the person can differentiate from what is good and what should be done, and what is not good and should not be done.
وَإِذَا عَمِلَ بِمَا تَعَلَّمْ يَكُونُ لِكَلَامِهِ وَقْعٌ أَكْبَرُ.
And when a person implements what one has learned, then one's words have a bigger effect on others.
الله تعالى يوفقنا لما يحبه ويرضاه.
May Allah facilitate for us what is good.
ويجمعنا على خير.
And may Allah facilitate that we gather good gatherings.
ويسر لنا سبل الخير.
And facilitate for us the paths of goodness.
ويوفق ويفقهنا في الدين.
And give us the religious knowledge.
ويجعلنا من الذين يبذلون جهدهم في خدمة دين الله تعالى.
And make us among those who assert their efforts to serve the religion.
وأسأله عز وجل أن يحيينا مسلمين.
Sheikh Samir says he asks Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that we live as Muslims.
وأن يتوفانا مؤمنين.
And that we die on Iman.
أن يحشرنا مع الصالحين.
And that we would be gathered hereafter with the pious Muslims.
تحت لواء سيد النبيين.
With the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم.
ويدخلنا الجنة ويبوئنا المنازل في عليين.
And that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will grant us paradise and the high rank in paradise.
وأن يجزي شيخنا الذي علمنا ما علمنا خيرا.
And that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will greatly reward our shaykh that has taught us what he did.
أسأل الله أن يجزيه عنا وعن المسلمين خيرا.
May Allah greatly reward him.
سبحان ربك وأن يرحم والدينا.
And that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will have mercy on our parents and forefathers.
وأن يغفر لكل من له حق علينا من المسلمين لكل من له حق وفضل علينا من المسلمين بهذا نختم كلامنا
Alhemdulillah, Rabbil Alameen.